And this one is Backbone. It is a an adventure noir-ish kind of thing. That I should actually hit that button and show on the screen. My controls. Run, crouch. The world begins with you. Not ends. The number of times I typed ends in prepping stuff for that. Yes, I know. We have a detective menu. So there's that. Also, you're a raccoon. In a bathtub with what look like film strips? Or like camera tape? That's not gonna develop well there. Sorry, Mr. Call. Yeah, no problem. 27 on the buzzer. Quick. Just enough time to clean up. I'm looking around and saying, press E to interact with objects. Case files. Inspect desk. Drag and drop items. Clean up. Dangly feet. Seems to be all I can interact with. Yeah, koala detective and now raccoon detective. Every form of wildlife is getting into this business. Damn thing stopped working a long time ago. Hit Frankie up next time I'm in Fussdale. Right? Notes on a fridge. Call mom, buy soap, pay bills, don't die. Priorities. Photochemicals. So these are photo strips. Just using the bathroom sink to do your dishes. That is the life. You know, don't die is high on my list. No music. Are getting some sound effects though. Looking for Detective Lodor. We spoke on the phone. Together you have a case for me, Mrs. Green. Debt? She's an otter. I understand this sort of thing is routine in your line of work. By your husband. Missing? Cheating? I'm inclined. But let's be circumspect. He hasn't been himself lately, getting home at odd hours, and every time I talk about it, he gets... Alright. This is kind of feeling like the rapper plot of Zootopia. Otter gone missing. You suspect he's cheating? Okay. Filing for a divorce. That's why you would bring up court. Need something damning enough that custody won't be a question. He threatened to take the children. Do we think it's relevant? No. Let me know how he caught whiff of the affair. He hasn't been hiding well. His behavior is all abnormal. He gets home late, misses work, lies, and smells funny. What's the funny smell? Perfume. Alcohol, smoke, an herbal stink? This game is set in Vancouver. I'm just saying. How do you know he's been missing work? Gotten calls, okay. Well, it smells funny. So it's a non-standard otter smell. Let's talk case details. What do we need to know? Where does he work? At the Wolf Bank. Met any of his friends? He's an otter, of course. A bit shorter than you, kind of chunky, wears glasses. There's a black briefcase to and from work. His full name, Jeremy Green, or Jez, or Jezza. I pick him out of a crowd. Green tie and hat for today. Yes, hand over that money. What assurances can you make that you're the right man for the job? Bet my tail you're here because someone recommended me. Are there others? It's confidential. Okay, don't get caught. We'll add that above the don't die on the priority list. Notes to self. Okay. Wearing a green hat. Okay. Inventory. Jeremy Green's photo. To the bank! I mean, I've been told Canadian raccoons are very clever. Squirrel. In this guy around? Are you some kind of no? The ultimate crime against fashion. Where did you get this jacket? Someone is missing. Your sense of humor. Huh. Can't tell you. Furman and Sons. Go crazy and kill someone if we can afford them. Can we kill the squirrel? I don't think the squirrel has it coming, but... Oh, that's a very good run animation. And the turnaround. Yeah, this is sharp visuals for sure. I'm looking for someone. Got a moment? Let's hear your story. You got a second kid, eh? He's as round as a beach ball. Woman, you're getting any bigger, and I won't fit you into a trunk of a car. Mean thing to say. Hand me the red honey. I don't get walrus humor. What does it mean? This guy's gonna go on for a while. If daddy has two baby bros to take care of, baby bros now have zero daddies. That took a dark turn. Let's make it topical. A missing person on my hands, his wife is pregnant too. It could be a walrus, could be a woodchuck, I'm not sure. It might be more woodchuck. Guys talked? It's too wasted to talk, okay. What do you smell like? The poopy butt kind of smell. Thank you, Anatoly. Alright, try the bite. So you know what? I strongly suspect that giving him a moment to tell about his family got him to open up. Funny. Ian Simmons is the rising jazz star. See her tonight, only at Bite Club. First rule of Bite Club. Let's talk to the bank employees. How are you doing? Is Jez around? Asshole owes me money. Do we play friendly or do we play hardball? I think we play friendly. You're probably not gonna see your money. Oh, okay. Derek's had a similar situation. Something happened at work. Contract is not gonna get renewed. Well, sucks for Jezza. Where do you think he headed? I mean, he is kind of an asshole, but I have a feeling there's a whole cluster of asshole in this environment. Reckon harlots are sort of girlfriends? Okay. He's have a blast at the bite every Thursday. He's not fun anymore. Luck, Rack. Yeah. I could, try and have a bit more conversation, but nah. Okay, we gotta talk our way into the bite. Or go down the alley. Control to crouch. Ah. Okay. Well, let's try this next. By talking to the bouncer. No entrance for raccoons. Well, I'm sure we can arrange something. It seems we cannot arrange something. Okay. Alleyway. Larry. Huh. I guess they have a previous relationship. Are you okay? Yeah, they have a history. Nothing serious, just messed up his marriage. I mean, given the situation Larry's in, I think nothing serious is an accurate description. Like, this is serious. Here's a photo. I don't know if the description would have helped. Not sure yet, but I think I know where to look. Let an old slug like me keep you. Don't talk like that, Larry. Do we offer a place for him to crash? I feel like they got a background. I feel like it's an obligation. All right, you're turning it down? That's fine. Okay, bouncer won't let me in. Really more of a cat and dog crowd. A disguise, eh? Let's say what do you think, Larry? A new objective. Is Alley Door for deliveries? We can ask Johnny. Tell me about Johnny, eh? Ah, the squirrel. He's a pusher. What kind of stuff are we talking about? Hype, catnip, and chatter. I'm gonna stop at this point and say, having written a furry novel, these folks did very good job of world building. Like you would think just like loop back and like make everything puns and references, but it actually like is it's fitting together. Monkey Butt, eh? Let's not ask about Monkey Butt. Think this Johnny guy would help? Might take some convincing. They've got colloquialisms. They've got species-based colloquialisms. Like, good show. He's friendly with the staff and I've seen him help people cut the line. Got some sort of partnership? Gotta be mutually beneficial somehow. I'm guessing Johnny supplies the drugs. What's he like? He likes his fur gel. Let's inquire about the drugs. New things to shit, perhaps a bit less figuratively. Does it have a kind of herbal stink? Yeah, what else you got? Who owns this place? Bloodworth. Crime family. Okay. Up to now, taking back the whole operation. So the place is respectable, what with the mafia ties and all. Drug distribution. Yeah, that's the mutually beneficial thing. Johnny's the hookup. What's on the second floor? All right, so Larry's a huge help. No answer on the intercom. All right. Crouch past this guy. Ecomart. McKinsey and Sons. People clothes, yeah. I don't remember from my time in Vancouver, but I think Granville is like it's one of the streets, not a separate city. I don't remember. But this association of like Granville and hoity-toity is kind of fitting. Granville Island, right. Okay. Yeah, that is the touristy area. Once I got punched by a guy in a fedora, who then proceeded to puke out his not nearly digested tuna burger on my coat. Ah, the memories. This rabbit has a mustache. This bunny has a stash. Take some fresh news. Day parade preparations. Celebration starts Friday. How's business? Why don't the cops care about the hawkers? Small fish, not worth the effort unless they're right under the cops' noses. Peddlers, yeah. Why do they bother you so much? They're not playing honest. Damn rodent with the seeds will be arriving in. Rodent with the seeds, eh? You got at least one loyal customer. I mean, we are busy, but also, yeah, I'm just gonna run away and try to not be a dick. I know I'm supposed to crouch here, but I kind of want to talk to Downey. Found a job yet? I have my own PI agency. I am a job. We're not being a cop. We're not copping it up. All right, so let's go back and talk to the squirrel. Because now we have some context around who he is and how he might be able to help. Johnny? E. Gerald Howard. Let's give her a name. Pretty name for a grown-ass man in a trench coat. I kind of wanted to just be direct. Can you get me in? I think we need to be a little circumspect with Johnny. You know exactly what I'm talking about. Lead me through the bouncer. Threatening, pitiful, congenial. I am a raccoon in a trench coat. Do you think I'd ask if I wasn't serious? I guess we be a bit harsh. All right, let's use Downy. All right, threatening works, I guess. I'm not instantly inclined to be a hard ass, though. I'm noticing like the parallax of the street, even. Like, this is solid pixel art. Holy hell. That's really good. Here's Johnny. Right, let's go in. Renee, Colby. Larissa. Another bouncer. And a door. Okay, let's just run inside. Renee. Well, you're unusual. Take that as a compliment. You're too young for a Howard. Well, I'm Howard tonight. And every other night. Have you ever snared anyone before? Investigative journalist, eh? I can see these two having a professional relationship over the course of the story. I haven't opened my my detective menu. Green was in the bite tonight and where he might have gone next. Right? Colby, what do you say? Looking for a friend. Let's go with that. Yeah, let's small talk for a moment. Sound like a big fan. Player often? Soften him up and then ask. Is his hat green? You have a briefcase with him? Do you see where he went? Well, the Afghan lady in the J-colored dress. All right. Looks sufficiently jade, given the lighting. Square-shaped glasses. Yeah, let's name drop. Forge crews tease him incessantly because he spends all his time here. What would you recommend I do? Get a drink. You work here? Could say I'm part of the staff. Alright. Are they like the... I don't know. I don't know dogs. That would not surprise me. Haven't the deepest pockets, but I do well enough. I think we need to play a character for a bit. All right. I'm exactly where I need to be. Yeah. Do I seem like I would start trouble? Well, my today's cover is a raccoon in a trench coat. I think we keep up the line. Ah, the owner. Very good thing that we gave a false name. Good range boy here to mix something up for you. I have no idea how many people are working on this, but it has to be several people, and they have to be really good at this. This is solid. We have lots to talk about. Why would I lie? Welp. So much for that. Find a way back inside. This seems like alley time. I think I somehow poked the bear. You don't yet, no first-hand experience. People don't change. You just arrived? Let's have a rooftop door. How are you gonna get on the roof? The press stand! We should know the bow is kind of a dick nugget. Well, who isn't? Alright. I know I've like gone on a little long with this one, but it's so solid. Don't mind me, just need to climb the stand. What issue do you have? A hawker over by Mackenzie's. The Pico with a cart. What do you want me to do about it? Okay. You there. A strange favor to ask. That's places other than Granville you can set up shop, right? Listen, do you have a seller's permit? It worked. We made an enemy, but it worked. Get him off Granville. That's so smooth. That's so smooth. This is some of the most solid pixel art I've seen in so long. Plus the animation. I might have to. This is just the prologue. Else to interact with. Your inventory. Bag of seeds. Gift box. Yep, Bite's definitely a brothel. Can't hear you when you crouch and don't see you behind dark objects. I got caught. I mean, this guy is not giving us much opportunity. Okay, so I need to just like follow at a good distance. Okay, there we go. Painting. A green tie is stuck behind the frame. A secret lift. And the green hat. Okay. What are they? Need some scissors. Freezer. Or a delivery schedule. Are you gonna swipe stuff for the girls? You need to make a note or you mess up the inventory. The other side of the intercom. We're in the freezer. You suck. Why the? Let's just hide back in here. Although I can't. Okay. I think they're not going to show up. Greg, are you stuck in the freezer again? Yes. Okay. Call the kitchen, someone will come get you. We didn't want to get caught. It's the same intercom you're using. It didn't do anything for me to just... I'm very confused as to what it actually wants me to do, though. Okay. Distracts two of them, but not the third. Hmm. How am I going to distract the third? Work. I wasn't about to ask too many questions on that front. So how do I distract the last one? Do this. Hit that up. Oh, this guy comes back. So I gotta be fast. to make this happen. Okay, let's start the sequence again. Keep turnkey downstairs by your station. The wall is an embrace. It sets the mind at ease and helps keep the city safe. Well, starting to think there's a bit going on. Five. What might be the code? I don't know, but at this point I feel like I have gone a bit long with this one. So, I will move it along, but that is... The visuals are extremely good. Extremely good. And there is just so much, like, so much personality about it. Yeah, that is going to, like, go on for a little while. I can imagine the full game is going to be very long. Yeah, this is slated to come out next year, so plenty of time for it. Yeah, like that's going on wish list, honestly. I do want to point out that the developer name is Eggnut, so there's that. But yeah, man, that is just ridiculously impressive visuals. And very solid world building and all of that. Yeah, I hope they can sustain that throughout an entire game, for sure.